So hi guys, welcome back to GK Code Labs. This video is part 2 of our discussion on transformation and actions with practical hands-on. Please check that I button and watch that video, as we have already discussed few transformation in that video. This is the continuation of that. So we have discussed till group by. This video we'll start our discussion with group by key. So suppose we are already creating an RDD from an array of key value pairs. So in such cases where we have to group by the keys given in the RDD elements, we can use something like this, and it won't require any arguments to be given because it knows we have a key value pair. So now let's put a collect action on this and see the output. You can see for A we are getting 3, 2 and 1 because A is 3, 2 and 1, and for B we are getting 5 and 4. So this is how group by key work. So now let's see our next transformation, that is map partition. So let's say we have an RDD with 4 elements, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So as you know, our RDD is a distributed data set. That means it is distributed over the cluster into different partitions on which different executors process them. So on the back end, they get distributed into different partitions. But let's say we have a huge data and we know that our first two elements is in one partition and other two elements is in another partition. So in such case, if you have been asked to apply some transformation on each partition, in such cases you have to use map partition. Let's see how. So here we have defined an array which has 4 elements and created an RDD from this. In parallelize function, we can define one more argument to explicitly define how many partitions we want when this data set is created. So let's suppose when this data set is created, I want it in 2 partitions. So I can define comma 2. So this will create this RDD into 2 partitions. If you want to verify, we can use partition size function and see how many partitions are getting created. You can see 2. If I define 3 here, this RDD will be created in 3 partitions. You can see 3. So syntax of map partition is, map partition takes one argument, suppose a function. This function is an iterator basically, which has to iterate over the partitions. It is little bit tricky, but I'll try to clear it with a small demo. So I have defined this function f. This is basically an iterator. This product iterator is a scalar function that will iterate through this array. Let me change this to 2 partitions only. So what it will do, it will iterate through all the partitions, and for each partition it will sum the value at this index and create a tuple with next value as a string sum. Now as I told you, map partition syntax, this will take this function as an argument. Let's assign a value to this. It will be x dot map partition. Now let's collect the value of x and y RDDs and let's see what we get. As you can see, x is obviously this array, but for the second one we have defined this array should be divided into 2 partitions. So it has divided this into 2 partitions, 1 and 2 in first partition, 3 and 4 in second partition. And once map partition ran, it has taken this iterator function as an argument, applied this logic to each value in different partitions. You can see 1 and 2, this is first partition, sum of this and a string sum we have got, and 3 and 4, and sum of 3 and 4 as 7 and sum string. So in these cases, when you have to explicitly operate on different partitions, you can use map partition function. So we have covered map partitions. Now let's see map partitions with index. So map partition with index is also more or less similar to map partition, but here you can make use of partition index also. Suppose we have 2 partitions. So first partition index will be 0 and first partition index would be 1. So in same iterator function, if you want to operate on partition index, you can use this map partition with index function. This also takes the iterator as argument, and once you run it, you can see we have divided it into 2 partitions. This is the first partition, this is the second partition, and it is giving us partition index of first, that is 0. 0 is 1 and 2. This partition is at index 0 and we are getting sum of this. So 1 and 2 is 3, and second partition is at index 1. So this is the index and again we are getting the sum. Also, one important thing here, you can see you are getting the output. In the output also, you can see you don't understand where are the partitions. We have created two partitions, but here it's not very clear. So you can use a function that is glom. Glom basically flattens the output on each partition. So glom.collect, this you can use. Now let's see the output. Here you can see, first it is flattening each and every partition. So array which we gave, this is flattening on each partition. First partition has 1 and 2, second partition has 3 and 4. And for the output, after map partition with index, we are getting at index 0, we are getting the sum, and index 1 also we are getting the sum. So it's operating on different partitions. So this was basically about map partition with index. Now let's move on to very important transformation, that is reduce by key. Suppose we have an RDD words with 6 elements. Some of them are repeating and we want to count which one is repeating how many times. This is also very simple use case of word count. So reduce by key is very helpful if you want to do word count on any RDD. Sorry, this is just an array, so we still need to make an RDD out of this. sc.parallelize words. And as we are going to use reduce by key, we have to generate a key against each and every element. So we have to process on each and every element. So simply we are going to use a map function, taking each element as word and generating a tuple like word and assigning a value 1 to it. Let's assign this to a RDD. Now simply we can create another RDD with word pairs.rdd and reduce by key. And this is the syntax for summing up all the values belonging to a similar key. Let's do a collect action on this and see the output. So here you can see 2 has come twice, 1 has come once, and 3 has come thrice. So basically what it did, it assigned 1 to this, then first 2 it has assigned 1, second again 2 came, it assigned 1. For each and every value, as you can see here, we assigned 1. Then for similar values, it has just summed up the 1. So as many times as they are repeating, the 1 is getting added and we are getting the count. So this is how reduce by key work. Now let's understand sample transformation. Suppose we have an RDD with so many elements. I'm considering 6 elements in this. And I just need a small sample out of these many records. If I need a small sample from this RDD, I can use a sample function on this RDD and create a new RDD. So this is the syntax, sample, false, and the fraction. This fraction should be strictly between 0 and 1. If you are giving 1, there is no use of sampling as it will give you entire array again. So here you can see you are getting entire array because the sample fraction we have given as 1. So you can give something like 0.4. And if you run now, you'll be getting some or the other data. This sample would change every time you run. You can see now again we are getting 2, 3, 5, 6. So this is just used to take small sample out of a big RDD. So that was about sample function. Now let's understand what is union. Again, as the name suggests, and if you have little understanding on SQL, you know what union does. But let's see how we can use it in RDDs. Again, it's very simple. Let's understand with this code only. Suppose we have one array X, and let's define one another array as 7 and 8. So as the name suggests, the union should ideally join this and this elements of both the RDDs and create a new one. So let's create a new RDD Z where we'll union X with Y and see the output with collect action. As you can see, we are getting an RDD with elements 1 through 8. So this was about union function. Now let's see joins. Joins are very important when it comes to Spark data structures, RDD or data frames. Let's suppose we have two RDDs X and Y with different key value pairs. In this case, what join will do, it will return a new RDD with all pairs of element having same key in original RDD. Like here A has 1 and 3. So after join, we should get 1 and 3 as pairs along with A. So let's apply join and collect the RDD. I'll run this. 1 and 3 against A with this join. One element as 1 and 4 because A has 1 and 4 also. And one element as B with 2 and 5. So this is how join will work. Now distinct is another very small transformation. Suppose we have an array with some elements as duplicates and we want just the unique ones. We can apply distinct function on that RDD and we will get the unique values. You can see duplicate 3s have been eliminated, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So this was about distinct. So now colies, key by, partition by and zip. These are some very important transformations that are also used in performance tuning of Spark applications. So I'll continue this in my next video. I'll link my next video in that I button. Please click on that and you will find explanation on remaining 4 topics.